Hello, namaste. Welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making kande pohe. Earlier I showed the video of batata poha and today's version is quick version that you can also prepare for your lunch box. I remember taking this kande pohe or batata poha in my lunchbox my mom used to prepare for us. And just one tip to share though, that if you're making this for lunchbox, instead of making with oil, try with ghee. Because we used to have a problem, the oil leak from a lunchbox and you know, mash many other stuff. But if you add ghee, then you won't have that problem. So let's start making kande pohe. And one more thing I do different with this recipe is that I add some anardana, the fresh pomegranate, but that's optional. Anardana will bring a lot of flavor. You can also sprinkle some sev on top. So however you like to serve, we can serve this kande pohe. Here I have the pot. Into the pot, I'm going to heat a couple of tablespoons of oil. Couple of tablespoons of oil. I'm just going to eyeball here. I add a little bit more than a couple of tablespoons. Here I have poha. I washed a couple of times and then soaked with little amount of water. Make sure that you don't want them to be soggy. So make sure to add, if I have a 1 cup of poha, then I just add maybe 3 to 4 tablespoons of water to soak this poha. Because you want to keep each and every grain of this poha separate. Poha is nothing but beaten rice. You can easily find this at any Indian grocers. And I'm using thick variety. For this recipe, always use thick variety. Your poha should be like this. You can see that each and every grain of poha is separate. Now, by mistake, if it gets soggy, then you can make the batter and make some dosa out of it. Here I have the onion. Of course, I'm making kande pohe, so I'm adding dungri. I happen to got this fresh pomegranate from our produce store, so I thought of making today kande pohe. And from spice box, I'm going to add some seeds and some powdered spices. I'm going to add mustard seeds. Let it splutter. Mustard seeds are popping, and I'm going to add cumin seeds, turmeric powder, pinch of asafoetida, hing, onion, carefully. Here I have the curry leaves fresh from my garden, mitho limro. Curry leaves, give it a stir. From my paste box, I'm going to use ginger and green chili. If you're not adding onion, you can also add garlic. Add ginger paste, green chili paste. Give it a stir again. Add coriander and a cumin powder. Let this cook a little bit. Now add poha, beaten rice, soaked for about half an hour. Now before I keep stirring, we'll squeeze some lime juice. I have the fresh lime up here. I'm also going to squeeze fresh lime. Wow, that was so juicy. Add salt, sesame seeds, and give it a good stir. Actually, I'm going to add sugar as well. Sugar is optional. If you wish, you can add, otherwise leave it out. Sugar. Now bring down the temperature because it may stick. So keep the temperature on a very low heat. So basically, this kande pohe is ready. That was real quick. You can also add some cashew, raisin. So you can season it up however you like. This is just a simple version of making it. I am going to add actually some cashews and raisins on the top. If you wish, you can add into the oil so that cashew gets a little bit started it, but it's really up to you. Here I have some pomegranate, it's anardana, fresh cilantro, dhania, and cashew and raisin. I'm going to top this kande pohe with this ingredients. I also have some sev, besan sev. I showed the recipe earlier how we can make the sev at home. So I'm going to take out this kande pohe into this plate here. Now on the top, some cashews, raisin, cilantro, and some anardana. And if you wish, you can sprinkle this sev right before serving. So I'm just gonna put just a few sev just to give a hint, like that. And look at this plate. Quick bite from this plate. Yum. So this was all about kande pohe. Thank you for watching and I will see you real soon with the next great recipe. I am making vegetable paratha.
Prepare the paratha stuffing, crumble cauliflower and cabbage, shred or crumble carrot. Heat up the pan on a medium heat with a tablespoon of oil. Add cumin seeds, jeera, fennel seeds, sauf, turmeric powder, haldi, green chili, ginger and garlic paste. Give this to all a quick stir. Add crumbled cauliflower, cabbage and carrot. Add some spices, coriander cumin powder, dhania jeera powder, salt to taste, amchur powder, dry mango powder if available, or else you can use lemon or lime juice. And if desired, boiled mashed potato can be added to get good binding. Sprinkle coriander leaves, dhania. Now to prepare the dough, into the whole wheat flour, add salt if desired, mix, a little bit of oil. And prepare the soft dough by adding little water at a time. Cover with damp towel and allow it to rest. The mixture has cooled down completely. Mix well with hands and prepare small balls. Golf size balls are just perfect. Now coming back to the dough, pinch about a little bit bigger than golf size of a ball. Flatten it out and roll with a little dry flour. I usually prefer to roll in a such a way that the middle is a little thicker and the edges are thin, and I'll tell you why. When you place the stuffing inside and when you gather all the edges, you're gonna have a lot of dough if you roll thick on edges. So that's the reason I prefer to roll very thin on edges. And now roll again into the circle, not too thin or not too thick. You may see the glimpse of vegetables, but not to worry. Heat up non-stick pan on medium heat and carefully place the rolled paratha onto the pan. When you see tiny bubbles, flip the paratha on the other side. If desired, smear a little bit of oil and cook both sides until you see brown specks. When done, take it off of the pan and bring down onto the paper towel. I love to top it up with butter. And serve with raita and pickle. Yummy! These yummy parathas are perfect for lunchbox even. My kids totally love them.
I want to show you leftover rice quick fix. This recipe is very comfy and you will make it again and again once you try this recipe. And I'm very sure that you will make extra rice purposely just for this recipe. So let's begin. So into this bowl, I'm going to take rice, leftover plain salted rice. Here I have plain yogurt, also known as curd, dahi basically, beaten. Next, here I have onion and carrot. You can add your favorite vegetables here. And here I have kidney beans. You can use your favorite beans. Basically, I'm just trying to add here calcium, protein, and some nutrition from vegetables as well. So carrot and onion going in. All I'm trying to do here is trying to add as much nutrition as I can. Yogurt is full of protein and calcium as well. And if you are following vegan diet, you can easily substitute dairy yogurt with soy yogurt. Now give this a very good mix. Perfect. I'm also going to sprinkle coriander leaves, dhania on top. Now a few tips here. You can add omit ingredients as per your preference. I always have boiled beans in my freezer. I keep it in freezer just because I have two growing kids and I always prefer to make homemade lunch for them. So I always prefer to keep boiled beans in the freezer so I can use anytime I want to. But if you don't have boiled beans, you can add peanut, mungfali, when you prepare tempering, which I'm going to do now. So basically I'm going to temper this rice now. The best thing I like about this recipe is that you can serve this recipe slightly warm or even cold. It tastes so amazing. So heat up the small wok on a medium to high heat. Add 1 tablespoon of oil, or you can use butter. Clarified butter, even ghee is perfectly fine. And here I have all the tempering ingredients ready. Curry leaves, whole dry red chilies, urad dal, ginger and green chili. And from the spice box, I'm going to use mustard and cumin seeds. When the oil is hot, add mustard seeds and let them pop. When the mustard seeds start popping, you can cover to prevent the mess. While mustard seeds are popping, I'm also going to add cumin seeds. Turn up the stove now and cover again to prevent the mess. And here I have urad dal, dry whole red chilies. You can add in the beginning, but I like the red color instead of black, so I add a little bit late. And at the same time, I'm also going to add now ginger and green chili, adrak and hari mirch. And I also got curry leaves. Now cover it. Tempering actually is the key to make this rice so yummy and flavorful. Oh my gosh, smells so good here. Yummy. You can take this yogurt rice in your lunchbox even. So enjoy however you like. Thank you for watching and see you soon.